So let us see the good morning all of you. So in the previous classes we discussed some problems based on the motion of the charged particle in combined fields, that means in the magnetic force and electric force. So let us see few more problems based on that, and after that I will discuss about force acting on a current carrying conductor. And so now here the note down this problem: a charged particle of charge 1 coulomb and mass 1 kg is released from rest from the origin. Is released from rest from the origin. An electric field E bar is equal to 10 I cap Newton per coulomb is applied for x less than or equal to 1.8 meters. And a magnetic field minus 5 k cap Tesla is applied for 1.8 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2.4 meters. And a screen is placed at x is equal to 3. Parallel to YZ plane. Find, so in that write the questions here. First question in that, find the speed with which particle strikes the screen. Find the speed with which particle strikes the screen. And the second question, find the Y coordinate where the particle strikes the screen. Find the Y coordinate where the particle strikes the screen. And the next question, find the time after which particle strikes the screen. Find the time after which particle strikes the screen. So, right? So, we know a basic point regarding that speed, that the particle is accelerated only because of electric field. That means the speed of the particle changes only because of this electric field. Because of magnetic field, the speed of particle never changes. Only the direction of motion of the particle may changes here. So once if you release the particle here, the particle starts accelerating because of electric field here until this 1.8 meters. So just you can write this work energy theorem here. So work done by all forces is equal to change in kinetic energy, I am writing. So work done is EQ into this 1.8, force into displacement is equal to half m v square minus 0. Initial kinetic energy is 0. We are releasing it from rest. And therefore, you can substitute those values here. V is equal to under root of 2 into EQ into 1.8 by m. And therefore, it is nothing but under root of 2 into E value is 10 and Q value is 1. And this is 1.8 by 1. So that you will get this V is equal to 6 meter per second. Right? And so then, one, that means when it crosses that 1.8 meters, its speed is 6 meter per second. And so even though it is traveling under the action of this magnetic field, we know the speed of the particle will remains constant. It doesn't change. And so that means the particle strikes the screen with the same speed here. So that means the particle is accelerated because of only electric field. And so particle strikes the screen with that same speed. So note down that. Therefore, here the particle is accelerated because of electric field only. So, the particle strikes the screen with a speed of 6 meter per second. And next here, they are asking that Y coordinate they are asking. So, that means until here, let us see the path followed by the particle further. Until here, it follows the same path here. It travels along the same line here until this point. So, now here the velocity is 6 meter per second. And the magnetic field here is into the plane here. That is already given, minus K cap. And so now let us see, field is inwards, particle is traveling along this direction, and so the particle will be, and that means the particle is turns into the circular path here. And so the particle turns into circular path. So let us find the radius here. So until x is equal to 1.8, particle travels along x-axis. So right until this point, it will continues travel along this x direction here. So now from here it travels with this, it enters here. So now the radius of this in magnetic field. In magnetic field, let us find the radius. MB by BQ. So M is 1, V is 6, B is 5, and Q is 1. Right? So the radius is 1.2 meters. But here the distance is 0.6 only, right? That means the length of this magnetic field in which that field is applied. And so the field will, the particle will undergo some deviation here. And so the deviation now we need to calculate there. So the particle cannot complete this total circle here, just it will undergo some deviation. So this is our radius. And so then this angle, if this angle is theta, then we know this angle will be theta. And so therefore the deviation we can write as sin theta is equal to x by r, you can write. So therefore this x means the distance in which this field is applied. So which is 0.6 by 1 by 2. So which is 1 by 2. So that is 1 by 2 means we can write this theta value as 5 by 6 or 30 degrees. Right? So that is the deviation produced there. And so now until here let us write the y coordinate there. So that y coordinate is nothing but, now I am writing, suppose say this is the point A and this is the point B I am taking here. And once the particle leaves the magnetic field, and so in this region from 2.423, there is no any field, there is no electric or magnetic field. And so in this problem, it is already, given that gravity is neglected here. You may mention that in the data, neglect the gravity. And so the particle continues to travel along this straight line here and it will strike the screen somewhere here. Because there is no any field, the particle will continue along the same straight line there, right? And so that this is the point C, for example. So we need to write the finally coordinates of this point C. So for that, the coordinates of point B I am writing here. So for coordinate of point B means you can write this value as r cos theta, you can write here. This side is r cos theta until here. So then y value we know that. The distance of y coordinate of point B I am writing there. The y coordinate of point B is nothing but r minus r cos theta, you can write. Is it clear? This distance we need to write. So this is r cos theta until this point here. So this total is r minus r cos theta. So 1.2 minus or 1.2 of 1 minus cos 30. So this is 0.6 into 2 minus root 3. So that is our y coordinate there. So that means this distance here, yb means. And so now we need to calculate this this distance, that c to this x axis we need to calculate there. So further you may calculate this distance here, cd distance, by using again this right angle triangle. So from triangle BCD. In the triangle, suppose if I write this, let us write tan 30 value. So tan 30 is equal to CD by BD. Therefore, that CD is equal to BD into tan 30. Right? And so then BD value is nothing but 0.6. This distance is again 0.6. So 0.6 by root 3, the tan 30 value. Therefore, y coordinate you can write this as y coordinate is equal to, you can write that y coordinate value as yb 0.6 into 2 minus root 3 plus 0.6 by root 3. I mean, sum of these two values. This value is 0.6 into 2 minus root 3 plus this value is 0.6 by root 3. You can simplify this, then you will get this y coordinate value here. 0.6 I am taking common, then 2 minus root 3 plus 1 by root 3. You can take LCM and you can simplify this. 0.6 into, so like this value is 2 root 3 minus 3 plus 1 by root 3. So 0.6 into that 2 you can take common there. So if you are taking this common 1.2, root 3 will be there. Root 3 minus 1 by root 3. So this is our y coordinate here. Y coordinate of this particle. And then you can also write that expression as next time taken we need to calculate there. So time taken we need to calculate. The time taken we can calculate again by parts like this. How much time it is taken to travel from 0 to 1.8 and from 1.8 to 2.4 and from 2.4 to 3. So like that by parts we need to calculate the time taken also here. So let us see now this time taken calculation here. So for this directly you can use s is equal to half a d squared term equation here. For this part, this time taken t1 I am taking, for example this is t2 and this is t3 I am taking here. And so now this part you can write this as 1.8 is equal to half into a into t1 square. So therefore this t1 is equal to under root of 2 into 1.8 by E cube by M, right? And so now you can substitute those values here. Therefore T1 is equal to under root of 2 into 1.8 by this 10. E cube value is 1 and M value is also 1. So then this value is T1 is equal to 0.6 seconds you will get. That is our T1 value. Next, the time taken T2 value in magnetic field you need to write. So in magnetic field we know how to write the time taken. Just we need to consider the angular displacement there. So for that you can write that expression as I can write this T2 is equal to theta into M by BQ we need to write. Right? So time taken in the magnetic field. So the T2 value is nothing but pi by 6. So pi m by 6 bq we need to write. So this T2 value is pi into 6 into 5. This value is 1. M is 1 and q is also 1. So that this value is pi by 30 seconds. Right? So that is our T2 expression there. And next the T3 we need to find. So for finding the T3, here in case of these fields are there, but here in this region field is not there. Just that constant speed means the distance by, you need to write that speed of the particle. So the T3 value is nothing but BC by V you need to write. So BC value is nothing but under root of BD square plus CD square by V. So therefore you can write this BD value as 0. BD means this distance 0.6 square plus CD we already calculated there 0.6 by root 3 whole square by the speed of the particle. In the previous calculation we already did that calculation. So then you will get this T3 expression like this. So then 0.6 you can take out 0.6 by 6 into, and the remaining value will be like 2 by root 3 you will get, right, if you simplify this. And so then you can simplify this expression as 1 by 5 root 3 you can write, right? That means this value you can write as 6 by 60, that means 1 by 10, and this is 1 by 5 you will get. So 1 by 5 root 3 seconds. And to find the time values, total time value, let us add all those values there. Then you will get this T1 plus T2 plus T3. And from that you can write this total time taken for this. So that is a way of calculating the time taken for that, right? So just add the total time is nothing but T1 plus T2 plus T3. So the total time is nothing but capital T is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3. Let us add all those values there. And sometimes they will ask, only in the magnetic field they will ask some angles there. Angle, that means how much angle it will come out, and such a type of problems will be there. Let us see one more such a problem, the angle deviation problem. Like suppose this is the region in which this magnetic field is applied here. So this distance is d, and a charged particle is entering here with some angle like 53 degrees with this line, and somewhere it is given that it is coming out here like this at some angle theta. We need to find that theta value. D is 3 mv by bq is given, 5 bq. So note down the data. A charged particle of charge q and mass m enters the magnetic field, with some speed v, making an angle 53 degrees with the boundary, If width of the magnetic field is, d is equal to 3 mv by 5 bq, then find the angle theta shown in figure. That means the particle comes out here with some speed v. That angle we need to find there actually. So right. So actually from this you can calculate how much deviation it will produce there, because we know the deviation formula. So the deviation, we can write this as sine theta is equal to, you can write this as general formula is x by r, you can write. So your x is nothing but d here. Therefore the sine theta is equal to, this is nothing but what we can write is 3 by 5 r we can write. So that means that value I am substituting directly there by r. Therefore that means this is not our theta, this let it be some phi. Because there already that theta is given, this is not that theta, just a deviation what we are calculating here. How much deviation is produced by this magnetic field? So let it be some angle phi. And so that this value is 3 by 5. So from that this phi value we can write this as 37 degrees. So the deviation produced by this field is 37 degrees. Now actually once the magnetic field is like this and the charged particle is here, the magnetic field is say out of the plane here. Once the magnetic field is like out of the plane here and the particle is entering like this, then the force will be directed like this. The center of the center of the circular path will be directed like this. And so now I am taking this line like this. And so now in this line it is at a distance of r, where r is given by mv by bq here. So where r is equal to mv by bq. Right. And so now that according to the given information here, this value is given as 3 by 5 r. So then according to from that calculation, so this angle is, 90 degrees and this angle is 37 degrees, you can observe here, right? Because this total angle is 180 degrees. This is velocity direction, this is a radius direction. Velocity and radius are perpendicular to each other. So this is 53 and this is 90, and so it should be 37. So if it is 37, here what we can conclude is, if you are forming a triangle like this, you can observe that this distance is d and this distance will be equal to exactly equal to r value. That means this is d means 3 by 5 r, and so that this value should be r. This value is r means what our conclusion is, the center of the circle will be lying on this boundary here. That is our conclusion here. If you know velocity direction, from that velocity direction what we can conclude is the center is lying along this line here. Particle will turn into circle, the center will be lying along this line at a distance of 3r by, that means at a distance of mv by b cube. And so now according to our calculation what we are getting is this, from here this r is nothing but equal to this value, that center will lie on this boundary here. So once the center is lying on the boundary, then you can conclude that the particle will follow a path like this. The particle will follow a path like this, and so this will also be the radius here, right? Because the particle is following a path like this. And so from this what we can conclude is the particle come out like this actually. The given diagram is like this. From this what we can conclude that the particle will come out like this, because this is the tangential. Velocity is along tangential direction. Tangent is always perpendicular to this radial direction here. So it must be perpendicular there. Therefore, our conclusion is the particle come out with this 90 degrees here. Therefore, theta is equal to 90 degrees you will get. So that is our conclusion there. That is the angle. So such a type of problems will be there. So just by doing such a type of calculations, you need to calculate the angle, how much deviation is produced in this given problem. And next, we discussed already, like in combined fields, we discussed one of the case like cycloid case. Based on this, some problems will be there here. So let us see the type of problems there based on that cycloid. So note down that problem. A charged particle of charge Q and mass M is released from rest from the origin. The electric field in that region is E bar is equal to E naught j cap. The electric field in that region is E naught is equal to E bar is equal to E naught j cap, and magnetic field is B naught k cap. Magnetic field is B naught k cap. So I wrote down the questions there. First question, then find the maximum y coordinate of the particle. Then find the maximum y coordinate of the particle. And next question, find the radius of curvature of the particle. Find the radius of curvature of the particle when y coordinate is maximum. When y coordinate is maximum or y displacement is maximum, right? And so we know when the particle is released from rest, what will be the path followed by that particle? We know the information regarding that. So it will follow some cycloid path here. So because of this electric field, it will start accelerating here. The electric field is along this direction. So E bar is along this direction. And because of this electric field, it will start accelerating along this direction. Once the particle starts accelerating, the motion of the charged particle, magnetic field is out of the plane here. So the particle force will be directed like this. So it will turn like this. So that means it will follow some cycloid path like this. So now this is nothing but our y maximum here. This is our y maximum. So it will be repeated. Cycloid path will be there. So the y maximum value we need to calculate. So that we need to proceed the same procedure as that of our complete derivation there. If you remember that displacement expressions, you can apply that. But there we derived by taking some different notations there. The fields or electric field is along x direction we consider there. But they are changing that coordinate system. So for that it is better to remember that procedure there. How we derived that expressions, positions of that particle, that means coordinates of that particles there. So for that, simply what we need to conclude is the motion of the particle is in xy plane only, confined in xy plane only. So let v bar is equal to vx I cap plus vy j cap, I am assuming here. So let us write the force acting on the particle here. So that we called Lorentz force. So f bar is equal to q into e bar plus of v bar cross b bar. So this is q into v bar cross b bar, means you can write this as e bar expression as e naught I cap, sorry, e naught j cap, plus this is vx I cap plus vy j cap cross b bar, means we need to take it as b naught k cap we need to consider. And therefore this expression we can simplify, you will get the force equation. This is the total our derivation process only. So then this is nothing but q into e naught into j cap. Now I cap cross k cap means then it will be minus j cap. So vx into b naught into j cap, and plus vy into b naught into this j cap cross k cap. J cap cross k cap is I cap, right? And therefore this f expression you can write this as finally. So f bar is equal to q into vy into b naught I cap plus q of e minus vx into b j cap. And therefore I can write this ax is equal to dvx by dt. So which you can write it as q into vy into b naught by m. This is fx component here. From that we are writing acceleration fx by m. Let's suppose this is our equation 1. And then ay equation, now I am writing here acceleration along the y axis. Dy by dt q of e minus vx into b by m. This is suppose the equation 2. Now we know the further procedure. We differentiate this equation again. So d square vy by dt square is equal to minus q into b by m into dvx by dt. So this remaining procedure is same as that of our derivation only. Just it is again nothing but revision of such a derivation there. So then you can substitute this dy by dx value here. If you substitute that dvx by dt value, so then this term qv by m whole square you will get into vy is equal to 0. So we compare with our equation d square x by dt square plus omega square into x is equal to 0. So we compare with this equation here. And so by comparing, what we can write is omega is equal to bq by m. And we write the general equation here. So that means we are comparing with this equation here. We compare with that equation and this is the omega value we can get. And then general equation we can write it as the general solution. So let v bar is equal, that means vy is equal to a sin omega t plus phi. So at t is equal to 0, vy value is 0. That is our net. That means now after taking this, we need to find this a and phi values, which are the constant, the maximum velocity, and a means maximum velocity and phi is the initial phase. So we need to find those two values there. So for that we need to use our initial conditions. Initial conditions is nothing but t is equal to 0, vy value is 0. That means there is no any velocity for this particle here. We substitute those values. So from this you will get phi is equal to 0 in this. So right, this is 0 is equal to a into sin phi you will get. So that sin phi is equal to 0 or phi is equal to 0 you can write. And the next to find the another a value, we differentiate that equation there. So if you differentiate that equation, a omega cos omega t you will get. I am taking phi is equal to 0 as we already concluded. So now again at t is equal to 0, the dvy by dt value we can write at t is equal to 0 by using this equation here. If you use that equation at t is equal to 0 means vx value is 0 because particle has no velocity either along x direction or along y direction there. So that means this value will be equal to minus plus eq by, means simply you can write eq by m. This is from equation 2. And therefore let us substitute their values here. Eq by m is equal to a omega into cos 0 you will get. T is equal to 0 means. So therefore it is eq by m into a is equal to, this value is bq by m. So that implies that a is equal to e by b you can write. Therefore our velocity vy is equal to, what you can write is e by b into sine of omega t you can write. So this is our velocity, y component of velocity expression. So now we need the maximum y value. So for that again we should integrate this equation here. Therefore dy is equal to e by b into sin omega t into dt. So then integrate this. Just I am writing this as dy by dt here. Therefore this is from 0 to y and this is from 0 to t. Y is equal to e by b into omega into, and this value you will get minus the constant I am writing here omega value and minus cos omega t you will get, and you can substitute that limits. So you will get like 1 minus cos omega t you will get. Right? And so now that is our y expression here. So from this y expression you can conclude our maximum y value here. So when that y value will become maximum? When cos omega t value is equal to minus 1. When cos omega t is minus 1, then minus of minus plus you will get there. Therefore, I can write this y maximum is equal to. So, therefore, this is y maximum is equal to 2e by b omega. Or y maximum is equal to this omega value you can substitute here. B into bq by m we are writing there. Therefore, it is 2em by b square into q. So that is our y maximum value. And the next what they are asking is the radius of curvature when y is maximum. So the radius of curvature when y is maximum is you need to find at this point the acceleration of this particle here. So at that point the acceleration of the particle is nothing but at this point the total velocity will be along this direction only. Vx value will be there, the total speed of that particle will be. And so now at this speed we need to find acceleration and then acceleration of the particle, and then we need to find that Vx value there, Vx, how much Vx is there for this. And to find that Vx value again we can substitute this Vy value in this equation and you can integrate. That is one way of calculating that, which we already did in our previous derivation. By substituting this Vy value, we can substitute this Vy value here. Then you can integrate this equation and so that you will get that Vx expression, or otherwise you can also do by work energy theorem here. So by work energy theorem, this is our second part here. So work done by all force is equal to change in kinetic energy. So now when it is traveling from here to here, I am writing here. So that we can write it as work done by electric force as Eq into Y maximum is equal to half m v square minus 0. This is nothing but now Vx you will get. Is it clear? You can substitute, one way is you can substitute Vy value here and then integrate both sides, you will get Vx value, and that procedure we followed in our previous derivation. Now I am saying that we can also solve it by just by applying the work energy theorem here. Because here work is done by only electric field. Whenever electric and magnetic fields are there, work is done by only electric field here. So when it is traveling a distance x, y, because we already calculated that y value here. So then you can calculate how much work is done. That work done must be equal to change in kinetic energy. Initial kinetic energy is 0. Now final kinetic energy is half mv square. So at this point that velocity will be only along this x direction here. That means this velocity will be, this will be the maximum velocity actually. That will be only along this x direction here at that point. And so that then that's all I am calculating here. So y maximum is 2, that means you can substitute that y maximum value here. Eq into y maximum is 2e by m into b square into q is equal to half m v maximum square. Therefore, our V maximum is equal to V maximum or Vx, that is nothing but. So, V maximum is equal to, you can write this equation as 2 into E by B you will get. because the remaining terms will be cancelled, e square by b square into 4 you will get. I am taking square root, then you will get that expression. Now from this we need to find the radius of curvature. You know, for finding the radius of curvature, we need to write this acceleration. AC, centripetal acceleration will be along this direction and velocity will be along the direction. So, V square by R is equal to centripetal acceleration, you can write. And so, now that centripetal acceleration is nothing but acceleration directed along this Y axis here. The acceleration directed along Y axis is nothing but the now centripetal acceleration. So, the acceleration directed along the Y axis at this instant means we need to use this equation here. So, then acceleration you can write that as, acceleration at that instant you can write that as. So, that means acceleration at that instant we need to write here to find this maximum value of this acceleration. So, the acceleration at that instant means then Vx value will be maximum you will get here, right? The acceleration, this is our Vx value, Vx or V maximum value which is perpendicular to that velocity. So, here our finding our centripetal radius of curvature means if suppose this is the velocity and this is the acceleration which is directed towards the center. Directed towards the center of the curvature. There the curve is different. It is not a circle here. So, it is a part of a curve. That means here if you are taking that, here you will get a small part of this curve you will get. So, for that we are finding the radius of curvature here. Right? And so that its acceleration will be the acceleration which is directed towards the center is nothing but our centripetal acceleration we need to consider there. And so that then this equation we need to substitute here. So, that acceleration along this y axis means you need to substitute this expression here. So, then in that let us substitute there. So, therefore that centripetal acceleration is nothing but Ay. So, that Ay value we can write as Q into E minus Vx means now we need to substitute this expression here. Vx value is nothing but. So, which is nothing but 2E by B into B by M. So, therefore, this AC value you will get this expression as minus EQ by M you will get. That negative sign indicates it will be directed downwards here. That means along the negative Y direction there. That is the significance of that negative sign there. And so, now we can find this radius of curvature there. Therefore, that radius of curvature we can write this expression as AC is equal to V square by R you can write. And therefore, by using this R is equal to V square by AC you can write. And therefore, our R is nothing but V square is nothing but V maximum square we need to substitute here. So, that is 4A square by B square. By this centripetal acceleration is nothing but EQ by M we need to write here. The magnitude only we need to write here. EQ by M. Right? And so, that this expression will be 4E into M by B square into Q. So, it is the expression for this radius of curvature of this particle there, right? So, it is the radius of curvature when Y is maximum. So, it is the expression for this radius of curvature. So, those are some problems based on the field and this combination of the fields. And in the next class, I will start that force because it is a new topic, force on the current carrying conductor. I will start that force on the current carrying conductors in the next class, right? Thank you.